So welcome back, student. Again, we are going to resume the lesson number 5th, National Vegetation and Wildlife. In this lesson, we have already seen the natural vegetation and wildlife of Brazil. Now we are going to look after the natural vegetation and wildlife of India. This is the lesson number 5th of Geography Standard 10th. So let us continue. So before going further, let me make you to look at the physical geography of India. So here lies the Indian. So we are starting from the top. On the north side, the Himalayan ranges we can found, the which is shown in the blue color. So Himalayan ranges, see the area which is covered by the Himalayan ranges. I just deliberately making you to view it, because based on it we have the divisions of natural vegetation in India. So this is the Himalayan ranges. So the range light right from the Jammu Kashmir to the Assam or Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, it is extended till here. So this is the region comes across Himalayan ranges. This is the northern plain. Okay, so this area, it comes under the northern plains. Okay, this is the Deccan Plateau. The Deccan Plateau, Eastern Ghats, Western Ghats part, and the Indian deserts. So this is the physical geography of India. Now let us have a look on the map, figure 5.3 of the textbook. So let us move further to our topic. Here we have figure 5.3. Based on it, we have some questions that we are going to answer. But before this, I just want you to go through this map with the help of the scale which is given here and the index. The evergreen forest. Now the part which is shown in the dark green color, that is part, it is for the evergreen forest. Now let us have a look where it lies. The Himalayan evergreen forest, so right from this here, right from the state of Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, few part of Bihar, northern part of Bihar, UP, Bihar, even in western part, eastern part of West Bengal, Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Bihar, Odisha. Here we have Chhattisgarh. So up to this region, which is shown in a dark green color, and even the western coast, whole western coast. Here is we can see the western state, the Maharashtra, Karnataka, Goa, Kerala. So on the coast of it, so we can find the evergreen forest where it receives more rainfall. Deciduous forest, which is shown in a fade green color. So in the central part of India, Madhya Pradesh, see Madhya Pradesh, again the few part of UP, Bihar, Rajasthan, not the Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, few part, Maharashtra, where eastern part of Maharashtra. So this part, even in Kerala, the few part of Kerala, Tamil Nadu's few part. So the deciduous forest lies, the thorny shrubs, where we can find the thorny shrubs where there is a lack of water, the thorny shrubs grows, especially the hot desert area, Rajasthan, Gujarat. So hot desert, and here lies the cold desert part, and even at this point rain shadow area, hot desert area is shown. The Himalayan forest, here lies the Himalayan forest. So this part, Himalayan forest, at the range of Himalaya, the Himalayan forest lies, and here lies the thorny shrubs part. and the coastal forests. So this is very less. Coastal forest here, number 1, 2, 3. So at this places the coastal forests are shown. So just go through it accordingly, so it will be better for you to understand. Question number 1. Which forests are found in western snow-capped region? So this is the western snow-capped region. All are western snow-capped region. So here Himalayan forests are found in a western snow-capped region. Second number. On which coast do you mainly find the coastal vegetation? We mainly find the coastal vegetation on the eastern coast of India. Only here, the eastern coast of India, coastal vegetation, coastal forest. Very few are here. Mainly on the eastern coast. Which type of forest occupies maximum area in India and why? So, what can you see here? Which type of evergreen or deciduous? The maximum area in India is occupied by the deciduous forest. Number second one. So, it is the deciduous. The maximum area is covered here. So they are found in regions where the rainfall is between 1000 mm to 200 mm. So these areas also experience hot climate. In a dry season, trees shed their leaves so that water is not lost due to the evaporation. For example, bamboo, peepal, teak, banyan, etc. So deciduous types of forest occupies maximum area in India. Where are thorny and shrub vegetation found and why? Yes. The thorny and shrub vegetation is found in a region that receives very less rainfall. That is less than 500 mm of rainfall and experience dry summers for a long period of time. Example, catechu, acacia, kejri and varieties of cactus like aloe vera and agave are found in such regions. The leaves of these areas, hot thorny shrubs, let me first show you. So the area it is shown here. The leaves of these plants are small in size. Also, the process of evaporation is very slow in these plants. Therefore, they have the capacity of storing water for a longer period of time. So, that is the reason. The thorn and shrub area. So, mainly desert area it is found. And in peninsula part of India. Where there is some lack of rain. So, it comes under rain shadow area. After crossing the Sahyadris. Now, geographical explanation. The following types of forest are found in India. The tropical rainforest. We can see the evergreen forest. In regions which receives more than 2000 mm of rainfall on an average along with abundant sunlight, evergreen forests are found. The leaves of the trees in these forests are broad and green. These trees have hardwood, heavy and durable. Example, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, etc. Also, there are various types of creepers found here. Highest biodiversity is found in this forest. Now, these are the examples of the trees. Ebony, mahogany and rosewood trees in evergreen forest. In regions receiving rainfall between 1000 mm to 2000 mm in India, deciduous forests are found. In dry season, trees shed their leaves so that water is not lost due to evaporation. For example, teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. are the trees found in these forests. Now these are the examples of the deciduous forest trees. Teak, sal, mango, peepal or banyan tree, neem, tamarind, babul, jamun and bamboos. So these are the types of trees that are found in deciduous forests. Regions that receives less than 500 mm of rainfall and experience dry summers for a long period in India, thorny and shrub type vegetation is found. The leaves are small in size, for example, catechu, acacia, khejri, and varieties of cactus like aloe vera and agave are found here. In swampy areas, estuaries and lagoons, near coastal areas having saline soils and moist climate, coastal type of vegetation is found. They are called mangroves or Sundarbans in India. The wood of these trees is oily, light and durable. In India Himalayas, in Indian Himalayas, three types of forests are found according to the altitude. In areas located at the highest altitude, seasonally flowering trees are found. In regions with medium altitude, coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir and at foothills, mixed forests are found. This includes both coniferous and deciduous types of forest. Here, the proportion of salt tree is higher. So here are the examples. The range has thick forest of pine, oak, deodar and fir, these types of trees. Now next part we are going to learn, we have already seen the natural vegetation of India. Now we are going to see the wildlife of India. Now India wildlife. Show the following animals in outline map of India in figure 5.5 with the help of sign and symbols according to their habitats. Answer these following questions. Now this question is already solved to you. Okay. And the animals are also shown to you. I am just going to highlight the animals and the places where they can found. So here index is given to you. You can look at here the Bengal tiger, number one. Number one option, the Bengal tiger. This mostly found in the part of West Bengal. Okay, the Bengal tiger. The title itself gives us the meaning where it can find. Then we have a lions. Lions we can find in Rajasthan, Gir National Park. Rajasthan, lions and crocodiles. In swampy areas, it is easily found. Here lies the crocodile, the area of crocodile. In the Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, and even the Uttar Pradesh. Then we have a swamp deer in the state of Assam. The swamp deer is found. I have a picture of swamp deer. Then we have the next olive ridley turtles. Olive ridley turtles, they are mostly famous in Odisha. These are the olive ridley turtles found in Odisha state. Great Indian buster, mostly found in Maharashtra, Karnataka, the Great Indian buster bird. Then gharials, that is alligators. Here already shown gharials, alligators, Odisha states and the Tamil Nadu states, and even the Uttar Pradesh states. Nilgiri Tahir goats, it's found in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So here lies it is. The Gangetic dolphins. Yeah. Uttar Pradesh and Bihar state. Busted. Then one horn rhinos. Assam is mostly famous for this one rhino. Okay, one horn rhino. So in this way you can answer. You better mark those places even in your map. Practice map skill. Practice the locations of the states with their capitals, so it will be easy for you to show these animals if the question is asked in the exam. Now this is the map of India. This is political map. You better mark these maps with name of the states and the capitals, and you're going to keep in mind the locations of the various states very easily. You better practice this. You can download this Google Maps by using Google Images. Now the question one, correlate geographical conditions and the flora and fauna there. Now here What are the flora and fauna? See, this is the relation of flora and fauna. Flora relates to the vegetation and fauna relates to the wildlife animals. Plants and animals of a particular area are known as the flora and fauna of that area. Now, what is the geographical condition? Now, just let's have a look how they're interdependent. There is a huge diversity in the flora and fauna kingdom. It's due to the factors like land, soil, temperature, sunlight, and rainfall. Plants occur in distinct groups of communities in areas having similar climatic conditions. The nature of the flora in an area to a greater extent determines the fauna in that area. When the vegetation is altered, the fauna also changes. All the plants and animals in an area are interdependent and interrelated to each other in their physical environment, thus forming an ecosystem. Similarly in India, also huge diversity in flora and fauna is found due to the geographical conditions existing there. For example, Great Indian Buster is found in the central part of Maharashtra, where the climate is dry. It is also found in the dry grassland regions, especially in the run of Kutch. So this is mainly because the bird eats insects, seeds, so which is easily available here. In the mixed forest region, tigers are found. The reason behind this is that the varieties of vegetation are found here, due to which the herbivorous animals are found in a great number. In this way, the flora and fauna of particular region are interdependent on the geographical condition prevalent there. The question number second, do you know some other animals too? Now, the student can write the names of the main animals which they know. For example, cheetah, Nilgiri, deer, bear, etc. Next question, show the habitats of tiger in India with their names on map. Now see, this is the question and answer is given to you. Now this is the map, and this map shows the location of tigers in the various states of India. From just 1411 in 2006, the country now has 2967 tigers. This is the updated figure in 2018. Up to the 2018, tiger population is counted, and these are the states. Now let us have a look. The Madhya Pradesh, here are the state Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, Bandhavgarh National Park. Here we have a Bandhavgarh National Park, and even the Kanha National Park or Kanha Tiger Reserves, we can find the tigers. Madhya Pradesh, it has. So the figure in bracket shows the oldest number, and the updated figure is given. Previously it was 300, now it is 526. So in Madhya Pradesh the number is increased. This is the source, the status of tiger in India, 2080, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change Department. So this is the authentic source. The green color shows the increase in tiger population, whereas the red color shows decrease in tiger population. So most of the part of India it is increased, excluding the state of the Odisha. Okay, the state lies on the eastern coasts. This is the thing, actually we need to take care of these things. Let's turn to the next. Now Uttarakhand, Jim Corbett National Park. Here lies the Uttarakhand here. So Jim Corbett National Park, the number is increased from 178 to 442. In Maharashtra we have Tadoba Andheri Tiger Reserves in Maharashtra. Here also from 103 to 312, the number is increased. Tadoba Andheri Tiger Reserves. Now in this way there are many tiger reserves, you can find it many more. The exact figure is and this number of states is given to you. You can search and find it out in this way. You can get that information. But the states like the Odisha and Andhra Pradesh, it is really...
Actually, the number is decreasing.
Next question. Why is their habitat found in these regions? Their habitat is found in these regions because they are mixed forest here and various kinds of herbivorous animals exist here on which the tigers can survive. India, now geographical explanation. India is also a mega diverse country in terms of wildlife. There are many species of wildlife in India. Elephants are found in a hot and humid forest. One-horn rhinoceros are found in a swampy and marshy lands of Assam. Wild ass and camels are found in arid lands like Rajasthan, Gujarat and Rajasthan. Snow leopard and yaks are found in the snow-capped region of Himalayas. Indian bison, deer, antelope and monkeys are found in a peninsular region. India is the only country in the world where both tiger and lions are found. River estuaries and coastal areas are homes of many turtles, crocodiles and gharials. The forest and wetlands are the shelters of a variety of birds like peacock, Indian buster, kingfisher, peasants, duck, parakeets, cranes and pigeons. All the species make it a land of unique habitat of wildlife. This is great Indian buster bird. Now this is the small kingfisher bird, the very well famous bird of India. This is beautiful bird, parakeets. There are also different types. I will show you the beautiful parakeets bird. Have a look. This is the bird crane. Crane. These are beautiful pigeons. Have a look. This is commonly found everywhere. This beautiful peacock, everyone knows. Many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction from India because of poaching, pollution and rapidly occurring deforestation. Example, cheetah. The government of India has set up the number of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries and biosphere reserves for the protection of wildlife and forest in India. So we must not let them to be a history. Need to conserve wildlife of India.